C'était le 27 octobre, groupes armés, force négative, zikatuattaquer face à l'état de Mangawa. Tukapigana nabo, wakanipiga risasi ku mguu, kwenyene yanguka wakaendelea kupiga mabombe pale, bombe eclair bombe kanikamata kuroho, ndo yenyewe nikamata ile siku. Kisha nikaenda wakanikamata basoda wenyewe tulikuwa nao wakaniwa kwa hospitali Goma. Tulifanya trois mois mu hospitali Goma, havikuwezekana. Nikaenda Kinshasa nikafanya demo, hawakuweza kuitosha. Nikaenda Kenya, hawakuweza kuitosha. Ndio nikaomba kuja hapa ende kusudi wakuje waitoshe. Ndio nilifikisha hapa. Mimi napona, nitarudia, nitaendelea kutumika kazi ya jeshi kusudi niendelee saidia population yetu na nchi yangu.
Charles is a 28-year-old Congolese soldier who was involved in a terror strike on his camp. It involved an explosive device being detonated in close proximity to where he was located. It was believed that a piece of shrapnel had entered his physical being through his neck and was lost in somewhere inside his chest cavity. Charles fortunately continued to be very stable. He had some other shrapnel injuries which were extracted by the local doctors. However, there was a shrapnel that had entered into his chest and located itself right here on this x-ray. I'll switch the x-ray so we'll probably be able to get a better look sideways. In line with the heart shadow, you can see a metal fragment right here. The surprising part is that if it was located in this position, it had traversed the entire zone of the neck, avoiding all crucial structures, including the food pipe, the breathing passage, the tubes that supply blood to the brain, the aorta that is the main hose pipe that supplies blood to the entire body from the heart, the lungs on the left side, the veins that bring pure blood back from the lungs into the heart, the tube that carries blood from the heart to the lungs, very, very crucial nerves, his voice box, many, many other structures. It had missed all of them, almost miraculously, and ended up in the heart, which was in direct relation to the heart, and it was mobile. It was moving with every beat. You will see this is exactly the point where the bullet was lodged. This is the anterior surface of the right ventricle. It is a very thin walled structure. It is that portion of the heart that allows black blood to be pumped into the lungs. That is, the lung, the blood is taken to the lungs for purification, returns back to the left side of the heart, and then is circulated to the rest of the body. It is miraculous that he survived a shrapnel injury to the right ventricle. It is normally a 4 to 6 millimeter thick walled chamber. The other important thing is the bullet was in close proximity to the most important tube that supplies blood to the heart. That is the left anterior descending artery. Now, the left anterior descending artery supplies 60% of blood to anyone's heart. So the bullet was almost 4 to 10 millimeters away from the anterior descending artery. We did this on a beating heart, used something we call a stabilizer. We positioned it in a way that we immobilized that segment of the heart, slit the muscle open, and extract the foreign body with a special set of tweezers. And all the while making sure that we do not open the ventricle. The possibility of opening the ventricle is always there, and the after effects are it can suck in a huge amount of air into the circulation, and that air could go anywhere and it could cause serious problems. His recovery has been excellent. He hasn't had much blood loss, and obviously he's on the way to recovery and on his way back home within a week after surgery, which obviously tells us as clinicians that his heart has recovered on time and does not carry any of the residual sequelae of any major heart surgery. And he should lead an absolutely normal life as anyone else, except the only remains of his experience would be a scar running down the middle of his chest, which will probably remind him and everyone else that he's undergone heart surgery. We do not see any long-term impact of this problem on his heart function or affecting his longevity in the larger sense of the word.
Balisema ndo kwa doctor wenyewe anaweza opere kwenye ile risasi liko.
In the history of war, there are very, very few people, probably less than a dozen, who have survived with a missile lodged in their circulation. or in the seat of the circulation, that is the heart. So that makes for a quite an amazing story.